Exactly.
All right.
I'll write my password down here. We'll trade slowly. tasks in the world. You couldn't guess I love Samantha.
Okay, why is there a question mark? Are you, like, posing the question to yourself or something? Oh. And I didn't want to say this to you earlier, but she is way out of your league.
Like you have any shot with James.
I do have a shot with James. He's madly in love with me.
He's madly in love with his own abs. He posts pictures on Instagram every other day. Like, dude, they're the same got freaking muscles. Nothing's changed.
Yeah. Well, at least he's hot. Samantha has, like, spiders in her hair or something.
She's got her own style.
Creepy vampire girl is not a style. It's a mental problem.
She's the original.
She's probably dating a 30-year-old tattoo artist named Butch.
That's it. I'm uploading this.
You wouldn't dare.
Done.
I uploaded mine, too.
That's not good. So the next time it'll be like somebody.
Yeah, no telling.
Yeah, agree.
You should probably get a new Twitter account, by the way.
Yeah, I probably should.
Good night's sleep.
You left him and then went home to sleep?
Sure. 7th.
7th?
Yup, one every spring.
And you live through the fall?
Oh, there's really nothing to it. Happens all the time, so you might as well make the best of it. Why don't you take a nap? I'll be quiet.
A nap? While my little John's up there racked in pain? When he's giving me my firstborn? No, I couldn't be so selfish.
Fine. Have it your way. This is the waiting room here, Mrs. Prudhomme.
It's Groton.
Thank you,
nurse.
Nurse?
Yes, Mrs. Groton.
Any news yet?
Nope. We'll let you know.
Would you care for a cigarette?
No, thanks. I don't smoke.
I'm Miss Murray, Judy Murray, and since we have to wait together, why don't we keep each other company?
All right. I'm Mrs. Groton, Nancy Groton. This your first?
How could you tell?
You don't look so good.
Have you already been through this?
Only once, 2 years ago.
What happened?
George gave me a fine baby.
Girl?
No, a boy.
That's tough luck.
Not this time, though. We've ordered a girl, and that's what we're going to get. The doctor practically guaranteed it.
I'll take anything as long as it's a baby.
I'm looking for a girl. A nice girl that I can make with and we can sew dresses together. You know, a woman gets lonely for female companionship sometimes. It would be nice to have a daughter that I can go shopping with. Someone to take back to the Vlass reunion.
Sounds wonderful.
We've already enrolled her for the class of 91. I'm sewing her a sweater with a large V on it.
Boys are nice too.
Our little Ralph is a cute fellow, but he's a father's boy, you know how it is.
Not yet.
You will.
Aren't you worried?
Nope, it'll be a girl, all right.
I mean about your husband.
George? He's as strong as an ox. He wants to have an even dozen. You know, sometimes I think the reason men like to have babies is so that they can get off work for a few weeks.
I heard they give them up the day after. After it happens.
Oh, it's not like the old days. When Lloyd had his first, they kept him upstairs for 3 weeks after he came home.
And now they start the walking the next day?
The very next.
At least that's what they did with George after Ralph was born.
I won't let them get John up the next day. I won't permit it.
You won't have anything to say about it.
The poor things had a tough enough time already. He worked right up until the last minute, too. He was at a late business conference with the boss when he fell. Well, he realized it was happening. He phoned me right away. Then he phoned his father. Dad's coming up to help run the business while John's recuperating.
Nice. My father-in-law came down after the first 4, but no more. He doesn't want to spend his 2 weeks vacation down here every year.
I suppose after the first few, your husband sort of gets used to it.
Oh, a little bit. Sure, after he had the baby, he was back at the office in 5 days.
It took George 10 days.
There's really nothing to it.
Why don't they tell us something? Why do they keep us in the dark? How are we supposed to know what's going on up there? My poor John, if only I could help him. I could just have this baby for him.
Relax. Take it easy.
We'll never have another, no matter how much he insists. I couldn't live through it again.
Okay, come on, sit down.
Hold.
I always bring this along for you.
Oh, no, I couldn't. What does you bear smile?
Come on, just a swallow.
Just one?
Now you'll feel better.
Oh, how about you?
No, thanks. I don't drink.
I always find it's handy to bring along to the waiting room. Last year, there was a first-timer here who drank the whole thing in one swallow.
I know how she felt. Weren't you ever nervous even for the first?
Oh, a little maybe, but it's so simple if you just relax and wait. There's nothing you can do.
If only there were.
This here is the waiting room, Mrs. North.
Thank you, nurse. Oh, how's John? How should I know? They don't tell me anything.
Since we have to wait, we might as well sit down.
That's all I've been doing for hours.
I go.
side over.
How is Robert?
He's pretty good for the 7th month. Is he still eating pickle sandwiches?
No, that didn't last long.
Poor John, he said he couldn't wait to get back into his old suit again and have his figure back. He hasn't been able to play tennis for ages.
Yeah, Robert took up ping pong.
Did you hear about the athletics club? They're putting in a special maternity athletics division.
Groovy.
Steve!
Grotte, was it?
It's Grotten.
George's all right.
Oh, yeah, just fine with flying colors and all. And your son, yes, and your son,
no,
and
a son.
Oh, well, we can have a football team with the family. I don't really mind at all.
A son.
And your daughter.
And my daughter?
And her daughter?
Wait, what do you mean? Which was it?
Both. Your husband had twins.
Twins?
Twins?
A boy and a girl, did you hear that? Congratulations.
Going.
Would you like to see them now?
Not the least of which was second degree burns on my backside.
Oh, please, first degree. funny. Did you see that little freckled girl in the front row with the gap between her teeth? She nearly laughed herself out of her chair. Man, I love that.
Okay, yeah, sure. Laugh it up. It was your job to remember the spritzer bottle and put out the fire before it occurred through the panic. I rely on you.
Hey, I grabbed the first thing I could find. After all, you were on fire. It could happen to anybody.
Maybe it could happen to anybody, but it just had to happen to you. Okay, so you couldn't find the spritzer bottle, fine. So you improvised. You couldn't grab the fire extinguisher. You couldn't grab the whipped cream pie. No, you just had to grab a jug of moonshine and splash it generously on my blazing backside. Where did you even find a jug of moonshine?
I thought it was like fake moonshine, and the audience loved it.
What I want to know is how highly flammable moonshine even got out there in the first place.
Sure, you didn't leave it out there. You do like to hit the sauce.
I enjoy the occasional cocktail, sure, but I do not drink on the job, and nor do I drink moonshine. And I never would have made such an amateurish mistake.
Could it be, I don't know. Could it be that you're just feeling threatened because you're not the headline clown anymore?
Look, Junior, I'm interested in my career. You've been stepping out on my gas, taking pies that are meant for me. Don't think I haven't noted the shameless things you do.
Hey, just because you're acceptable and amazed to me, it's not my fault. You shouldn't make the audience suffer because you're timing them.
Kiss my butt. Who died in one of you clown prints?
Jealous relic.
Amateur.
Fossil.
Anarchist.
Serious?
Don't call me serious.
Solemn, grave, grim reaper. Serious?
You little twit, don't call me serious.
I just don't think you have any more. I mean, God knows you had your day. And you still appeal to the generic crowd. I mean, I remember used to break up when I was like, you know, 5. But lately...
I tried to befriend you. I was the one that got you in clown school after that long fan letter you wrote me.
Oh, so what am I supposed to do? Kneel down to just buy 15 shoes the rest of my career?
Just a tiny bit of gratitude would be nice.
Look, Sid, I've thanked you plenty of times. Thanks. Thank you. I can't thank you anymore. Life goes on.
And I got you this job in this circus. I did that because I thought you were a talented clown, not some cut-up, not some showboat, but a team clown.
Well, I appreciate the handout, but times are changing. And if you can't keep up, maybe you should think about retiring.
Retire?
Look, if you want to outstay your freshness date.
My family's been in this circus for 4 generations. My father's father's father, Doinky the Great, originally was the first time in Black Lake. He was a pioneer.
Look, old timer, you have your place in clown history. I'll give you that. But if you want to know the grim reality, the word around the town today is, this is not as funny as he used to be. He's lost a step.
Who says that?
I'm not going to name names, but I mean, look at the facts. They've cut your soul up down to 2 minutes. You used to do what? 15? For God's sake, you follow the lions when everyone's taking a pee of popcorn break. The only moment is boys when you do that butt on the fire bit with me. When you think about it, I'm the only one keeping you in the circus. Maybe you ought to be thanking me.
Don't think I don't see what you're doing. Sucking up to the bearded lady, showering her with bonbons, all because she's the wife of the ringmaster.
It's a dog-eat-dog world out there, my friend. Kids being churned out of bus, out of clown school by the busloads. Only the strong survive. You gotta be edgy, you gotta be radical. Me? I'm the blazing new ground.
You sick freak. Just stay out of my way tonight, all right? That's all I gotta say.
Sure thing, Pops.
I saw that.
Good, just see if you can pay attention. Keep you on your toes.
A banana peel in the trailer. Really? That's not funny. Out in the ring, with proper rehearsal, that's funny. A classic bit. But in here, that's just dangerous. Somebody could break a hip.
You're right, Sid. I'm sorry. Truce.
Are you serious? You want to shake my hand after you've tried a banana peel?
Are you refusing? Look, Sid, I want to make up. I'm sorry.
Sonja, you cannot, little...
You're not thinking, old school. You're so slow to see that popular label.
You are a dead clown. That's what you are. I'm going to get you tonight.
Bring it, friend. Let's see what you got. Keep it real. Mix things up. Speaking of mixing things up, you could mix up your makeup.
There's nothing wrong with my makeup.
White and green and a little orange. White, green, and a little orange. Same old, same old. People want to see wild things. I mean, look at my wig. Multi-hued, burst of color, spiky, sharp. This is tremendous.
That looks like my nose in your basket.
And you're losing your eyesight too, old man.
Let me see that nose.
This nose.
Yeah, let me see it.
You mean the nose my granny got me upon graduation from Clown Academy?
Granny, my butt.
Watch it. This nose was given with love.
That looks like the nose that Bingo Beluga bequeathed me with when he retired. And you know, there's a way that I can tell if that is really my nose because it's inscribed. So why don't you just hand it over and we can clear this all up real quick. Just hand it over. Hand it over.
Take it, if you can.
Oh!
5 minutes, you clowns!
I'm ready! Okay, that was funny.
Finally, after years of rejection letters and endless nights editing my works, getting recognized for something. I get to get all dressed up and receive my award on stage and look out to the audience to see my gorgeous husband and my beautiful daughter. I want to share this experience with my family.
Well, maybe you need to stop sharing every single thing you have with your family.
Excuse me?
Maybe I'm sick and tired of my entire life revolving around you and Dad.
What's wrong with you?
Nothing!
April, I'm not stupid. I'm your dad. I know when you're lying to me.
It doesn't matter.
Yes, it does. It's my job to do what's best for you. And this? This isn't it, April. This isn't who you are.
Do you want to know what's best for me? Stay out of my life. No matter what I do, I get overshadowed by you. What a brilliant man. So strong, so brave. Such an amazing writer. Well, you know what? Maybe for once, I want to be the priority. But all you care about is writing your little memoirs about how hard it was growing up being gay.
What just happened?
David, I can't do this. Do you know how hard it was to deal with the fact that my own parents wouldn't show up to this? My daughter looking me in the eye and telling me she wants nothing to do with me either? Just, no matter what I do, I can't please anybody. First my parents don't accept me, and now neither does my daughter. I can't do this. I'm not going tonight.
Tom, let me talk to her. April?
No.
Yes. April, we need to talk about
what's
going on.
No, we don't!
You know your dad's right about this. You used to be so happy. Your smile would brighten up a room. What happened?
When I walk into school every day, I'm not April. I'm Thomas Dwyer's daughter, or the girl whose dad is that author, or...
Just say it.
Or the girl with two dads. I'm not me, I'm just that girl. When I go to the store to pick something up, people whisper about me. I don't get invited to parties because people say my home life is just wrong. Do you know how cruel people can be? They say horrible things about you too. They look at me and they think, wow, that girl must be so messed up because two gays don't know how to properly raise a child. I'm done pretending like I'm okay with this. I'm a joke, and it's all your fault!
Listen, I don't think you're mad at us.
Yes, I am!
No, you're mad at how inconvenient we are for you.
Yeah.
Listen, April, we're gonna be together and people are gonna judge us. We'll go out as a family and people are gonna talk. It's inevitable. Even your daddy's own parents don't accept who he is. Sure, we're not the norm, but we're still a family. Do you have two loving parents growing up? Well, there you go. Most kids nowadays have to grow up with one parent or someone they're not even related to. Half the people who are harassing you don't even know what they're talking about. We have more of a family than all of them. And when you needed someone, were we always there? When you were scared, sick, or sad, when you needed someone to check the closet or under the bed, or read you a bedtime story. When someone had to follow you around with a dustpan and broom to clean up the messes you made along the way. Well then what makes us different than any normal family? Just because you have two dads, doesn't mean you yourself are any different. And if people think otherwise, let them. They don't need to understand. As long as you do, they don't matter.
Sorry. So sorry.
It's okay.
I'm gonna go get ready. Give me 5 minutes.
I just remembered. That is why I married you.
Oh, hey, it's 5:45, but we're gonna be late.
What's a few minutes late gonna do?
Aww. Garçon.
Oui, mademoiselle. And how is your soup?
My soup has a fly in it.
No!
Yes?
Oh, la la la! Yes, I see him. He's looking at me.
It's most distressing.
Indeed, mademoiselle, indeed. I'm at a loss. Who is your waiter?
I'm not certain.
Jock! Yes, yes. Madame, how is your soup?
Well.
Your soup contains a fly.
No!
Ah, oui! Outrageous!
Madame, did you ask for this fly in your soup?
No, I did not.
No, it is not fly soup.
No, it is not. It's definitely not.
Who is your waiter?
Well.
I will kill you.
Oui, your waiter must die.
Point it to me. I will tear him limb from limb.
I'd rather you didn't.
Your waiter will pay for this fly with his life, hmm? No? Just a fly. Today, just a fly. Tomorrow, a ball of hair. A wad of chewing gum. The next day, a human head.
See, like, has to be gone.
I don't want to make any trouble.
Nonsense.
Absurd. Mademoiselle's customer is always... is always...
Eh?
Right. We assume you. We will simply kill your waiter. Problems. The soup is not the issue.
Honestly?
The issue is the fly.
Exactly.
The fly. The fly must die as well. Yeah. Are you insane? And Paul defends this creature many trying to keep warm. And you suggest it ends its existence.
Hold on.
That's the point. Obviously.
Forgive me, mademoiselle.
Of course.
Stupid. The fly is innocent.
Obviously.
A babe insane. The fly has been duped.
Duped?
He is merely a bomb in this devilish blood.
And they would.
Yes, poor fly. Boo hoo. But might I just.
Poor fly.
You have now a bond, a kinship.
Eh?
With the fly, whose life you have saved.
Exactly. May I offer you a German visit? You want potatoes in the day for your fly.
I don't want this fly.
Of course not.
What would I do with the fly?
Well, you have saved his life, madam. In some cultures, but I overstepped my bounds.
Always right.
Is that right? I don't mind that. We can certainly make arrangements with this fly. He needn't be of your concern. Do not think again of this fly.
Thank you.
Dearly, be assured. This fly will live out his days in comfort.
It's a comfort of soup.
You idiot!
Sorry.
All I really want is another.
Madame, what have you ordered for your next course?
The souffle.
Oh, la la la, c'est souffle. Have some wine, you've died in guns.
May I assume, madame, that you did not order any flies in your souffle?
You may assume that, yes.
That is a no?
Most definitely no.
Pierre, s'il vous plaît, inspect madame's souffle. Tutti souffle.
Oui.
Madame, the souffle will contain no flies.
Yes, thank you. Really what I most desire.
You have a desire, madame?
Yes.
You need only ask.
A soup. One without the fly?
Of course! You would like your soup returned to its original fly-free condition. If you will permit me, I can remove the fly. Unharmed, of course.
Why would I... Are you saying...
The souffle will have no flies!
Excellent!
I have seen to it! The chef was quite upset.
Upset? I didn't wish to upset the chef.
Nonsense. It is your right to upset the chef. You have a grievance. Do not concern yourself with the chef. He is insignificant.
And since he never goes,
perhaps I should kill him.
Jeff.
Apologize to the madame for accidentally putting this petit fly in her soup.
Ah, the junk. It wasn't an accident.
What do you mean?
Do you see that? Candle over there, Jean.
Oui. What about it?
What is today's date?
April 1st.
You saw it!
Hey! It was only a joke. No need to flip out.
Did you say?
Oh.
some more. Yeah, to forgive is... is...
Yes, very well, thank you.
To forgive is bovine.
Bovine?
Our way sublime. My semen, auxiliary. A cow is not sublime.
No, I don't think that's it.
Pierre, you contradict the customer.
Not at all, it does not sound correct. To forgive is sublime?
Absurd! Is it not sublime to forgive?
Yes, of course, but what am
I will kill you!
Please! Please, garçon!
Oui, oui, monsieur.
This is unbelievable! Outrageous!
But of course.
And the fly is flown away.
What? You stupid! You scared away my tongue's fly!
Unless he's sunk to the bottom.
Allow me,
mademoiselle. A bowl of air. A wad of chewing gum. A human head.
No, it's tomato.
But of course, it is tomato soup.
No, a old tomato.
Francois!
Oh!
Because you are too loud. You're a loud, sweaty man, and this fly is gone. Of course, he has flimsy goo, his petite twins, heavy with soup.
It's cold. My soup is cold.
Cold? Incroyable. This is not cold soup.
It is shameful.
Madame, would you agree that this soup should not be good?
Yes. No, I don't want cold soup.
Very well, Pia, what are you waiting for? Rapidemo, a fresh bird piping hot soup for the madame.
Right away.
Wait, wait. Madame, would you like your soup piping hot?
Piping?
Scalding, fiery, blistering.
Well...
Puis wait till you're warm, tepid, so you don't burn your petite tongue.
I don't want to burn my tongue, but I don't want to take a bath in it.
As the fly has. Oh! Your soup will be perfect. Pierre, tutti soup.
Oui.
And Pierre?
Oui.
Without the fly.
Is strictly prohibited by
get home and see my wife. It's her anniversary. Tell Captain to get us off the ground.
Well, congratulations. I'm surprised I'm allowed more than 1 year with you. Well, hello there. My name is Ellen. I've been a flight attendant for East West Airlines for 10 years now. Sure, the skies have been a little rough. You know, dealing with lost bags and bad weather and trying not to slip a Xanax into a drink when someone just won't calm down! But that's neither here nor there. You know, I just don't think a job exists where you don't want to throw a person out a window.
Mom, I'm hungry.
That's good.
Mom, I don't have any service. How am I supposed to check Instagram?
That's good.
Ma'am, I. Oh my God!
I calm down.
Ma'am, I. Ma'am. Ma'am. Excuse me.
Thank you. seconds. There are six, count them, six emergency exits on board this aircraft. Two in the front, two in the back. One by Mr. Sunshine.
Excuse me?
And one by the reason I won't be having any children. In the unlikely event that pressure in the cabin drops, oxygen masks will appear above your head. If you're traveling with small children, I'm sorry. If there's anything I can do for you, or if you have any questions, please let me know. As soon as we get to Oklahoma City. And if there's anything you can do to make my flight more enjoyable, I'll be sure to let you know. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the flight. Or sit up and be tense. It doesn't really matter to me. Welcome aboard.